SEADOM, Congress, EPA?
Yeah, that's cool.
Okay, we'll go down to the last slide and then I'll work my way up. If only because, if only because if I explain the complex to you, I could explain some of the thought processes that have been going around. The visual and performing arts is the combination of art, music, and drama in the National Institute of Education. There's a reason it's called the national, not a national, because we are the sole provider for all teachers in the 360 schools in Singapore, primary and secondary and JC. This is very much the desire for learning outcomes from the ministry in 2008. Not much is going to change come 2015. In fact, they're going to sort of collapse, understand the role of arts in daily living and discern and understand practice into one, to look at global and local perspectives. So you can see that the community that we serve will be a six-year-old learning about music in a very non-specialist environment. What I think some people call the sensuous enlivenment of the beginnings of making and performing and responding to. Scroll up to the next second. So it's back to front, literally. Sorry, I'm being retrograde in perspective. Sorry. These are the programs that we currently train and prepare students for. So there's a diploma for primary schools and for secondary schools. In the diploma program, they've got single subject specialization in music. In the secondary, they're expected to do two subjects, one of which is music. At the undergraduate level, that's exactly what we do as well. So the primary is only about music. In secondary, they're expected to do music and drama, maybe music and math, music and English. And so they appear either as music as first specializations or music as second specializations. We also have, to use the entrepreneurial spirit, tagged in some of our courses with as access for students who may have done ADRSM music or have done IB curriculum music, but are now specializing in biological life sciences, but want to do a minor in music. And so this is how we get access to them. We've also had graduate programs involving Master of Education. Master of Arts and PhD are by research only. And some of our MAs have involved students looking at, say, a work by Chen Yi, analyzing that work, and writing a compositional response as part of that thesis. So there's a combination of exegetical writing, and of course there's a compositional response, which has value. There are professional development courses that we run with a new agency called Singapore Teachers Academy of the Arts. The professional development side of them, where some of these teachers come back to us for 4 to 6 months in a year, two semesters, and actually become involved in music making in a more specialized way to raise their proficiency. Finally, we are still the only institution that have been producing diploma programs for specialist wind band directors. And we are currently involved in collaboration with the National Arts Council for arts practitioner diplomas. So these are practitioners. These are the ways in which, if they end up in the school system as allied music educators, there are certain processes by which practice is translated into pedagogical discourse for the classroom. I think I will stop there and let you watch the video, because it would be a little bit more revealing. I could explain all of the other boring text later. Music compilation?
Sorry?
I think so. Yes. Thank you. All of these happen every 12 weeks into the semester. So what you saw in the gamelan was stuff they started rehearsing in January. What you just saw happened this Wednesday. So that was a performance. That was developed by one of the students. We lost the gamelan tutor. And I guess being political here when I say the Ministry of Manpower has got what to answer for in Singapore. But thanks to that particular restriction, one of the students in there said, will start the gamelan ensembles because of prior training elsewhere. And that's led on to another. And so that's completely student-led. In fact, on the 10th of May, this particular group will be visited by the Hong Kong Institute of Education because they saw them and they would like a gamelan workshop for 43 of their second year students from Hong Kong. So, you know, student-led ensemble. We're hoping for more things to happen. The pop band is entirely theirs. They choose their instruments, they choose their ensembles, they work out their repertoire. They've got to explain to us in journals. Fortunately, that's a written component. But they have to explain how this connects them with 6-year-olds, 10-year-olds, 14-year-olds, learning how music is vehicular access to their own lived experience. The boom whackers, again, was something that they asked if they could do, because they were so excited by boom whackers, they thought, well, we can do more than just playing rhythms. And of course, in that particular event involving the boom whackers, they had Coldplay as well. But, well, this one, too. We go back to the third last slide. Okay. And it's now possible for me to explain to you by demonstration of what our students do, what we think, and what becomes our driver in a way, because then we look at the philosophy of the arts as object and subject of inquiry. And of course, as he says, aesthetics is a discourse of the body. Moving on up. And so what is education in and through the arts? And this is an anthropologist called Tim Engle, whom I've used for a particular publication. The life activities themselves are not generative or personal, but ways of bringing established identities into play. And listening to Dr. Subri this morning, it wasn't about commodity fetish where, you know, we take the symphony orchestra because that's what Mercedes-Benz will buy into. We take that despite, you know, that commodity fetish. And as well, we look at what feeds into a local community. It's not what you do, but the received attributes that you import through these various projects. Moving on up. Okay, I think that's my last slide. And this is Clifford Pierce, who's done cockfighting, I think, in Bali, and has written a book about anthropology. We all begin with the natural equipment to live 1,000 kinds of lives, but end in the end having lived only one. And so the choice of one life from many options is a much better option than one life lived without any other opportunity. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Jenny from the Yong Tutor Conservatory of Music in Singapore. This August, the Conservatory will be celebrating our 10th anniversary for you. There's going to be a number of significant events that we'll celebrate throughout the year. But we would like to extend a special invitation to all SEADOM members to join the Conservatory Orchestra's opening concert on the 4th of September. It will be conducted by guest conductor Robert Spano, who is music director of the Aspen Music Festival. If you were able to join us around that date, if you hope and is interested to find out more about what we do at the Yong Tutor Conservatory, we would welcome you very much to join us for a couple of days where we could show you around the school, facilitate some opportunities to meet with students, faculty, show you around the building. The conservatory would find ways to offer support for accommodation if you can find your way to Singapore. That's all. Thank you.
My name is Ching Mai Thu. I am the deputy dean of the National University of Art Education in Hanoi, Vietnam. First of all, I'm very happy because it's the first time we are to enjoy SEADOM. The first university in Vietnam is our university. We the center researching on art education and music education and culture of art. We have eight faculty about music education, fine art education, cultural management, fashion studies, painting, graphics, design. We have three levels about training of music. We have three levels. First of all, Master of Music Education, Bachelor of Music Education, Diploma Music Education. Especially, we have a choice group. But the choice group from university is very, very famous in Vietnam. I'm proud that is. Yeah. You are welcome. You come to in our university. Thank you very much.
I am Luk Chabara from Royal University of Anna, North and Kabore. I think Joy show something this morning for my permission from the school. I got to tell about the Royal University of Anna. Yeah, I'm sorry that we have not yet the website. I want to tell about the history that formed in 1965. At the time, we have not yet for the music teaching, like higher education. So the faculty of music was opened in 1988. So after the war, and me the first promotion that started from 1980, and at that time thank you for Vietnam teacher come to teach us. Then I got my study in Bulgaria, Europe. For each year I got my master's degree, and now I'm a dean. And the faculty of music is one of the five of the faculty in the Royal University of Anna. The other are fine art, architecture, archaeology, and choreography art. So we teach in one area, and we learn each other. Especially in faculty of music, we teach and Western musical, and traditional musical and vocal instrument. So we have three departments. We have instrumental department, we have vocal and musicology. They are composition, conducting, and theory of music. Our students, when they graduate, they will be musician, like performer, music teacher in secondary school of music, and school of education, some program. And if HCMC that, we will select to be a teacher in the faculty of music. We have three activities. The first is training, like program teaching, how like by program.